Cause it's TNT. Dynamite.
The safe is full of dynamite.
We take. Yay. Dynamite.
This package of explosives is one of the deadliest objects on the planet at this time, but not for much longer.
Huh. I guess not anymore when it explodes.
The tricorder detects nothing unusual.
Wake up.
I'm afraid he's not in a mood for a conversation, Jim.
That's all right, Bones. He was rather boring anyway.
Haha.
The man is unconscious, Captain.
Well, we need to put through a transfer.
Captain, why do we need to take these documents?
We need to alter the documents.
Jim, I hope you're not expecting me to carry.
I do not believe that is necessary, Captain. I found the initial mind meld to be uncomfortable. I do not believe this would be a useful action. I do not understand the reason. I don't understand.
We need to get the other Horcrux. I'll get the last Horcrux.
Human male unconscious. Human male unconscious.
Let me just save just in case. Save.
Save new game. Replace.
Wake him up.
Hypo. I have a bad feeling about this.
How are you doing today?
The commander of this armory, if looks could kill.
Yeah.
You'll never get me to talk.
I would prefer that you didn't. You're nothing but a figment of Trelane's childish imagination. You're even less important than he is. Where's Trelane? Where's my crew? I would prefer that you didn't. Where's Trelane? Where's my crew?
I will tell you nothing. You'll never get me to talk.
I would prefer that you didn't. You're nothing. I would prefer that you.
I will tell you nothing. You'll never get me to talk.
I would prefer that you did. You're. Where's Trelane? I would prefer that you didn't. Where. You're nothing but a figment of Trelane.
I will tell you nothing.
Oh, nothing's working. What if we remove the ropes?
I suggest caution. He's a trained military officer. Giving him freedom without covering him with a weapon is not a good idea.
It's not very friendly, Commander.
Doctor, my job is to tell you the situation as I see it, not as I'd like it to be. If you think that being friendly to people loyal to Trelane is useful, tell me that I'm wrong.
He might be right, Bones.
Alright, aim the rifle at him.
Kirk, even primitive firearms can be deadly. If you fool around with them, I'll have to ask Dr. McCoy to relieve you of command.
We're supposed to be covering him.
Kirk, even primitive fi- I suggest caution.
It's not very f-
Doctor, my job-
He might be right, Bones.
Well, we can't really do anything.
I suggest caution.
It's not very f-
Doctor, my-
He might be right, Bones.
I do not believe that is necessary.
Captain,
only the commander can sign the transfer of papers.
Okay, so maybe I select him and he covers him?
No, Captain.
It's like he directly answered me.
I do not understand.
Jim, let's not fool around with high explosives.
All right. How do I do this? I want to... wake him up, which we did. Threaten him with the rifle. Maybe I just talk to him again?
You'll never get me to talk.
I would prefer that you didn't. I would prefer that you didn't.
I will tell you nothing.
How do I threaten him with the rifle?
Captain, I don't think he's a threat anymore. I suggest caution. He's a train.
It's not very friendly.
Doctor,
he might be right, Bob.
Jim, it doesn't make sense for me to revive him.
Captain, only the commander can sign the transfer of papers.
We're supposed to use this on people. Male human in good physical condition, despite the presence of stimulants and depressants in his bloodstream.
Stimulants and depressants in his bloodstream. For some reason, I find that rather funny.
Phasers are still
So how do I threaten him with the rifle? If I can't... How else would you threaten someone with a rifle than point it at them?
Kirk, even primitive
The commander of this armory, if looks could kill.
I suggest caution.
It's not very friendly.
Doctor, my job.
He might be right, Bone.
Captain, why do we need to take these documents?
So I can't remove the ropes, and I can't use the gun on him. What the hell are we supposed to do?
A safe. It is open and empty.
Get more. Don't we have enough of those damn things?
Get more?
Don't we have enough of those damn things? Don't we have enough of those damn things?
Aim the rifle at something else? A light?
I see no reason to kill the lights. I see no reason to kill the lights.
Break a plank?
Kirk, even primitive firearm. Captain, I don't think he's a... Kirk, even primitive. That's a horrible thing to do to a perfectly good telescope.
Haha.
Kirk, even primitive.
You presume to threaten me, Colonel?
I want you to sign works? Transfer papers for Sundergaard's son. Send him away from the front.
How typical of the press. Not too willing to sacrifice for the good of the nation. Untie me, and I shall sign papers to take this little coward away from his duty.
Was I not aiming it correctly?
You'll never get me to talk.
I would prefer that you didn't. Where's Trelane? Where's my...
I will tell you nothing.
Papers?
The commander's desk, covered with papers. papers on the commander's desk.
There does not appear to be anything relevant to Trelane here.
Do we have these papers? No. Or just enough that he signed them. Let me make sure I don't have to get anything.
Captain, why do we need to take these documents?
These, okay.
You have taken the signed transfer papers.
Nice. I guess maybe I wasn't aiming it right if I was like over here or something. I don't even know. But he wouldn't let me use the rifle. Stinker. Interfering with the mission. Now I know there's something before I leave here.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete. Replace.
I'm gonna like resave because I think you lose points for this stuff.
Kirk, what do you think you're doing?
I hear you Americans like to have gunfights and shoot people and send them to Boot Hill. Are you going to kill us, sir?
Absolutely.
Kirk, what do you think you're doing? Kirk, what do you think you're doing?
I hear you Americans like to have gunfights and shoot people.
How sad. Let's just, go shoot us up a cat.
Hello.
And I'm not gonna keep these actions.
He's done nothing to warrant that, Captain. I didn't think our mission was to terrorize animals, Captain.
Pretty sure we lose points for that. Go back. See how other people react. Oh, you know, there's soldier. Hold on. What about the soldier? What if we decide to put him out of his misery? So horrible. That's why after this we'll restore our save and it'll be like nothing ever happened. Imagine if we could do that in real life.
Jim, don't be a fool. He's done nothing to us.
Hold up. My phone. I got my timer going again.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Blam blam, kid.
That's sick, Kirk. Don't even joke about that.
Cowboy diplomacy will not solve anything, Captain.
Actually, that's more like suicide.
Cowboy diplomacy.
Poor unsuspecting human beings. Lying here.
Kirk, even primitive firearms can be deadly. If you... Kirk, even primitive...
Let's load. Okay. Imagine this game actually let us blow and look their heads off.
Save new game. Cancel. Replace.
Captain, I think I probably should handle anything like that from now on.
Oh, you don't have a problem with killing him. You want to be the one to do it.
Captain, I...
Okay.
Welcome, friends. Can I help you?
What can you tell me about? What can you... I need you to spread a rumor. What can you tell me? I need you to spread...
You say you need me to convince Herr Schiller to give you the kindergarten blackboard? I do not know why, but I would...
So we actually have to give him the papers then. Oh, we haven't looked at these papers yet.
These transfer papers will enable an enlisted man to retire from the trenches, perhaps saving his life. Hmm.
An ordinary piece of paper made from the pulp of dead trees.
Okay, let's give him the paper. For you.
Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel. I cannot express my gratitude. If there is anything I can do for you, please let me know.
Yeah. I already asked you to do something for
Welcome,
me.
Welcome, friends. Can I help you?
What can you tell me? What I need you to spread a...
You say you need me to convince Herr Schiller to give you the kindergarten blackboard.
I thought he was just saying the same thing for a second.
Anything for the man who got the commander to issue a transfer for my son. Welcome, friends. Can I help you?
What can you tell... What can you tell me about the war?
Okay.
Nothing would give me great...
All right, good. So now we should be able to return. To the schoolhouse. And, somehow he will convince them that chalk is deadly, something like that.
Oop. Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about the war? What can you tell? These children are something, aren't they? I didn't realize they let... You know, I've heard that chalkboards can... What do you think about... You know...
You want to remove my chalkboard? Nein, absolutely not. I wouldn't consider it enough.
Okay, crap. We need to speak to the superintendent, who was right back in that same room. Sorry, guys. Do everything manually around here. He was right in the next room.
Herr Kirk, though my position as school super...
You look worried. It wouldn't happen to be about the chalkboard by any chance.
I have heard the most horrifying rumors about these boards. Do you think they are true?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
If you wish, I could dispose of the thing for you before anyone is harmed. I'd need a letter for Frau Hubberding.
Absolutely. Let me just take pen to paper.
Oh, pretty handy.
Take it when you want to destroy the vile thing.
You totally bought it.
Herr Kirk, though my position...
Thank you, Herr Schiller. I don't think I require...
Any time, Kurt.
Okay, letter?
A letter from the superintendent authorizing the disposal of the chalkboard.
We take? We still only got
the Trelane paper.
That was a long episode.
This letter from the superintendent gives you the authority to confiscate the chalkboard.
Well, Spock's probably just gonna say it's, you know, from dead trees. Oh, wait. But let's just check.
An ordinary piece of...
Yep. Okay, let's go. Now we can head back. To the school and give Herr Fräulein the letter. For you.
Well, if the superintendent says you must take it, you must.
Told you. Thank you. He shrugs. What's that? I'm expecting that to work, Kirk.
An early blackboard. a wonderful innovation in education.
Yeah. He's gonna say it's very powerful for the chalkboard.
Captain, the chalkboard's power.
Yes. Alright. So I know exactly what to do. Now that we have the last Horcrux and the TNT. Yeah, this is not a Harry Potter guy game, guys. I just like to call it Horcruxes, because we have to destroy them. It's like from a lich's phylactery, or whatever you call it. All the sources of his power. Now, before I do anything rash...
Save new game. Replace...
Put this in the plane, because I noticed that was working before.
You put the chalkboard in the triplane.
I'm glad it actually is the correct thing to do, because I was kind of semi-panicked when I couldn't get him back out again.
Affirmative, Captain.
Here we go.
Everyone stay well back.
Bada boom. Lay down, your CP. You're a little too close to it still. Hello?
I suppose I should be angry at you, Captain, with your act of vandalism against my beautiful aircraft. But then, barbarians will be barbarians.
There's only one barbarian in the room, Trelane, and I'm looking at him right now.
Exactly what I was thinking.
Release my ship, Trelane. And don't you ever grow up, Trelane? You may have powers of a god, but that doesn't even come close to making you a man. There's only one Release my ship, Trelane.
My ship. My ship. It's always your ship, your crew. Don't you have anything else to think about? Conquests of your enemies and the fair sex.
Restore the ships you've stolen and return them unharmed.
You're in no position to make demands.
Oh, no?
I am the Baron of Gothus, the most renowned aristocrat in this part of Germany.
This farcical, wildly inaccurate fantasy of yours.
And you are my prisoner, a mere Lieutenant Colonel Jimmy Kirk. And I will do with you whatever I want.
Sounds suggestive. Well, let's look around the entire area. And us.
James T. Kirk, looking very concerned. Dr. McCoy, not at all pleased to be in the same room as this madman. Mr. Spock, wondering how they can surmount this problem.
You and me both, Spock.
Weird stuff, Mr. Ellis thinks. Why did I have to get mixed up with the Enterprise and their weird stuff?
Weird stuff. So yeah, as far as this point, I really was only looking at the walkthrough to find out how to get past that section. Spotted the part with the retired man in the apartment. And yeah, found out how to get those transfer papers signed. That was really annoying. So, as of now, I'm blind once again.
If the real thing weren't bad enough, a portrait of the humble Baron of Gothos smirks nauseatingly at you. These candles illuminate Trelane's self-portrait. An axe and shield. As with most of Trelane's collection, they are mostly ornamental.
Gargoyles? A scared pig?
An ugly gargoyle-like decoration.
A trifle grotesque for the setting, isn't it, Trelane?
Why, Kirk, I wasn't aware of your interest in the design of castles. I hope you like my rug better.
I'll check it out in a minute.
An ugly gargoyle-like decoration.
A trifle grotesque.
Oh. Why, Kirk?
Say that every time.
An axe and shield. These candles provide lighting for this gallery of Trelane's castle. An ornate table. The magnificent floor of Castle Trelane.
Oh yeah, so magnificent.
This bottle contains a very realistic reduction of the SS Shinobi, a freighter.
It is a Shinobi, okay.
A charming brick fireplace. Logs. A door, but to where?
I don't know, lady.
This seems pointless.
One of these other ships, what's this?
A poor bear rug.
Yeah, we're not impressed by that either.
This bottle contains a very realistic reduction of the SS Manikir, a Denebian transport.
I wonder if one of these is the Enterprise.
This bottle contains a very realistic reduction of the USS Zimbabwe.
My ship! Bring it back or I'll...
Oh!
This one's even more savage than the last one of your officers who made the same mistake. My compliments, Captain, on having such a spirited crew. Truly a testament to your fine leadership.
Release him, Trelane.
Thanks.
He's done you no harm. Take me in his place. He's not a member of my crew and you know it. Besides, he looks rather peaceful standing there. Release him, Trelane. He's not a member.
Are you trying to use me, Captain, to solve your own discipline problems? Take care, Kirk. No one uses the Red Baron of Gothas.
Oh, jeez.
I'm glad to see the deep concern you show for the men under your command. I am truly inspired by you, Kirk.
Huh. Okay, well, we didn't check out the last ship.
This bottle contains a very realistic reduction of the USS Enterprise.
Jim, is that what I think it is?
It is the Enterprise, Doctor. It is functioning normally, aside from being trapped. The crew are alive and well.
My latest hobby, gentlemen, putting warships in bottles, celebrating the grand martial heritage of your species.
Trelane, the Baron of Gothos, smirks triumphantly as the little drama unfolds.
Yeah. What do we have to say?
All right, Trelane, why don't we end this farce? I'm the one who humiliated you. I'm the reason your parents punished you. Let the others and their ships go free.
Last time, Captain, you cheated. But if your friends are here, maybe you won't cheat.
Kinda just want to talk to people and stuff.
Well, this is another fine mess we're in, Jim.
Any ideas on how to get out of this, Bones?
Well, looking at it from a medical perspective, we might view Trelane as a biological control network. And everything else that's going on is controlled by Trelane.
And?
What happens if Trelane loses control? Immaturity does seem to be Trelane's only weakness.
That's dangerous, Bones.
Like playing with a phaser on overload, but that's the only thing I can think of right now.
Interesting, though. He mentioned another fine mess. That's actually one of the quote-unquote episodes in the 25th anniversary game.
I can suggest no logical course of action that can resolve this dilemma.
This is hardly a logical situation, Mr. Spock.
Indeed. Still, I wonder if Trelane realizes the extent of his misrepresentation.
Well, how does the great James T. Kirk get us out of this mess? Or the ones who will get out of this mess alive?
None of us will get out of here alive if we don't stick together. Do you have any ideas, Mr. Ellis?
Have you ever played hide and seek, Captain? From what you've told me, he's a cosmic child hiding from his parents. If I were his parents, I wouldn't leave him alone for a minute. I'll bet my life that someone's looking for him, Captain.
You just might be right, Mr. Ellis.
That's nice. Mr. Ellis is starting to cooperate now.
Nothing. It's as if he weren't there.
You know, like in his brain or something.
No unusual readings.
No anomalies, Captain. So we'll scan everything and then we'll talk to Trelane.
Captain, the painting is another power object. Purely decorative, Captain. The shield is too thin to withstand actual combat. And given the inefficient design of a pole arm, the axe head would likely fly off the handle the first time it was used. No unusual readings. fascinating, Captain. The tricorder indicates that the laws of time and space do not apply outside that door.
My, we are curious, aren't we, Mr. Spock?
Always.
I believe it was the Kaiser who once said, curiosity kills animals with pointed ears.
I doubt he said that, unless you made him, which is possible.
The tricorder detects nothing. Nothing unusual. Nothing unusual about.
Okay, let's save here.
Save new game. Cancel. Save
new. Yeah, new game. I don't even know what we're up to anymore. What if we try to leave?
Trying to escape, Kirk. Oh, I didn't think you were a coward.
We'll just blast our way out of here, into a place that has no laws of space-time.
Why, Captain, do you need another demonstration of my flawless abilities in marksmanship?
Sure, you shoot the door then. Nowhere else to go, right? You got stuck. Nope, nowhere to go. Alright.
Jim, what would we want with a gargoyle?
Oh, yeah. Take stuff.
Why, Captain, it is a handsome portrait. If you think you can destroy it, I would think again. This one's positively indestructible, just like its subject. So you like my rug? I killed the creature myself, hunting alone in the Arctic wastes. That was before the war, of course.
Of course.
Perhaps it will make a perfect shroud for you, Kirk. After I've dealt with you once and for all.
Of course.
The hospitality of Gothis is yours. Feel free to warm yourself at the fire and admire my trophies. Oh, a duel with axes! How positively savage! You never failed to disappoint me. However, I am the greatest aerial combatant this pitiful planet has ever seen, and as such, cannot indulge myself in such wonderful barbarism. I will have to find a more civilized way of killing you.
Nah.
Why, Kirk, you're a thief! I also have an exquisite silverware collection.
Whack.
Put the stick away, Jim.
Kirk, we're going to need all of our wits if we want to survive. Put the alcohol away.
I don't want to get him drunk. This we don't want to do. This, like, kind of ends something, I think. Something I managed to peek at. Let us load, in case I lost some points for messing with things. Alright, let's just talk to him.
Well, Captain, I suppose you're about to make your grand plan of escape.
Thinking about it.
You must think you're pretty clever, Trelane, with your replica of the First World War. Why should I have to make a grand plan to escape from a loser like you? I don't have to do anything. Eventually, your parents are going to find you and discipline you again. You must think you're pretty clever, Trelane, with your replica of the First World War.
Right.
Why, thank you, Captain.
I wasn't complimenting you, Trelane. I've never seen such a piece of nonsense in my life. Although you could have made that trench scene much more realistic. If World War I had been the way you depicted, human history would have been a lot less bloody.
True.
If World War I had been the way you depicted, human history would have been a lot less bloody.
Let's go with this.
Are you calling the Baron of Gothis a liar?
Not a liar, just misinformed.
Right.
Use the memory banks of the Enterprise, Trelane. Recreate what's in there. War at its most realistic and terrifying. Not a liar, just misinformed. Use the memory banks of the Enterprise, Trelane.
Huh.
Recreate what's in there. War at its most realistic and terrifying.
That was different. Oh, yeah, it's a little more like it.
Trelane, The Baron of Gothos seems delighted by what he is seeing.
Delighted?
A dead French soldier. He survived a mustard gas attack at Ypres. But in this war, luck is not on anyone's side. A German soldier. Though you couldn't tell it from the color of his uniform, mud has a way of making them all look the same.
I like the descriptions here.
A German soldier. He had lost his three brothers at Verdun, and had considered mutinying, but feared disgrace more than the loss of his own life. A dead French soldier. In his hands, he cradles a letter from his fiancée. The sides of a trench. Moats filled with soldiers in which they besieged each other for four bloody years. Rain has been falling for hours, ever since the battle ended. Otherwise, all is quiet on the Western Front. The sides of a trench. The sides of a trench. Rain has been falling for. Rain has been. Rain has been falling for hours.
Is this another body?
Rain has been falling. The sides of a trench. Rain has been.
Okay.
Ah, good. Let us drink a toast, Captain Kirk, to good enemies and the glory of battle.
I'll pass, Trelane.
Ah, yes, the greatest weapons of humanity evolved from such humble beginnings. My dear Captain Kirk, are you always calling your ship? Have you no sense of privacy?
Yeah, no sense of privacy.
Captain Kirk, I hope you had a good reason for dragging me out in the mud in the middle of the rain.
Look around you, Trelane. Is this glory? Is this valor? Smell the stench of death. While knights fought in the sky, millions died in the mud. Diseased, starving, mutilated. Is this the sort of game you want to play, Trelane?
Good one.
For once in your life, Trelane, shut up and look around you.
Also pretty good.
Look around, Trelane. Take in the ambience, the romance of this place. Look at the proud soldiers celebrating the glories of war. Look around you, Trelane. Is this...
But these people lost, Kirk. Shame and suffering is supposed to befall the losers in war.
These were the winners, Trelane.
Yeah. Everyone's a loser in war.
You're inhuman, Trelane. You play games with people and ignore their suffering, just like the people who sent these men to die. You should have been a politician.
Good one.
If you have any real courage, Trelane, if you want to experience real warfare, put yourself in their place. No powers, no titles. Experience the glory of war firsthand, like these men did.
I am nodding here. You can't see me nodding, but I am.
These were the winners, Trelane. If you have any real courage,
like
Trelane,
three
if you
and
want
one.
To experience...
But aren't you inferior supposed to die like that? Aren't you supposed to throw your lives away in futile wars? Or die as meaningless non-entities? Dying a useless death without glory?
No one is useless, Trelane. And no one wants to throw away their life in a futile war. We've changed, Trelane. We've grown up. It's time you did too.
You're right. No fun anymore, Kirk. No fun at all. You're preachy just like them. Anything I'm interested in is always wrong.
Release my ship. Trelane, look around you. Does this look right to you? Trelane, you don't go around hurting people and expect them to treat it as though they're having fun. The first thing a life form learns is to avoid pain. Release my ship. Trelane, look around you. Does this look right to you?
That one's good. I think
Trelane,
this one's
you don't
better.
Don't go around hurting people.
Then how do you explain this delightful scene around us?
Some politicians decided that delightful. The only way to avoid getting hurt was to send other people out to get hurt. We've tried to outgrow that.
Not always successfully, as Mr. Ellis might tell you, but we try.
Captain, yours is a most confusing species. Perhaps I should spend some time thinking about it before I talk with you again.
You should. I remember that sound.
Captain's log. Missing starships have been restored to normal size and are about to return to their assigned missions. It was horrible, Mr. Spock.
Hope it did okay.
Trelane recreated one of the greatest tragedies in human history. I've seen a lot, but even that...
The waste of lives is appalling, even when one operates by pure logic. When one considers what those millions of lives that were lost might have done for humanity had the war never taken place. We received a message from the Zimbabwe. It left rather abruptly.
A shame that Mr. Ellis and I could not have settled our differences. He might have made a good officer for the Enterprise.
Unfortunately, Captain, life doesn't always go the way we'd like it. Happy endings are things to be cherished.
It's different seeing the bridge like this. Who's this?
Hello, Captain.
Blonde?
I'm Captain Gernsbeck of the Shinobi.
Oh, my.
I thought I would thank you personally before we left for Seth.
That's right.
A pleasure to meet you, Captain.
Have we met before, Captain? There's something familiar.
Perhaps we did, on some other planet, in some other star system, sometime long ago.
Not that long ago.
Message from Starfleet Command.
On screen.
I have reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments. The top brass at Starfleet are impressed with the results of your recent performance.
Good.
Outstanding work, Jim. Keep up the good work. Kane out.
Sounds good. Preview for next episode. Light in Darkness.
Captain's log. While exploring an uncharted star system in the Deneb sector, we received what we think is a message from a distress beacon on Onias 2. We're en route to investigate.
Not that much of a preview, but a preview it is. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure, and live long and prosper.